Hello and welcome to the channel Automation Step by Step. I'm Raghav and today is Friday, so let us begin our QnA Friday episode. And the question that we are going to take up today is how to check technology stack of a web application. So before I start explaining and give you the answer of this question, let us first understand what is a technology stack and why should we know the details of the technology stack of a web application before starting automation testing. So technology stack is all the tools, technologies, programming languages, scripting languages that are being used or that are used to build that particular web application. So for example, a web application can be built over Microsoft technology stack and can be using .NET, C# or Microsoft servers. And then it can be using different JavaScript frameworks or programming languages as well. Now, why is it important to know about the technology stack? Now, in case you are working with a third-party clients and you are not completely aware of the application, about the technology, about the programming languages, about the JavaScripting frameworks that are being used in developing that web application, then it becomes very important that you know about these things before you start automation testing or even before you start your feasibility analysis. Now, one of the major reasons that you should do this is by doing this, you will come to know that what will be the right tool or what will be the right framework that you should use in automation testing. For example, if it is built over AngularJS and you start your automation framework scripting over Selenium, then in the future you might face some problems. So if it is AngularJS, you might definitely want to go with some AngularJS libraries and tools like Protractor and things like that. Again, the other thing is it will tell you their technology stack, their programming languages. So for example, you have selected Selenium as the right tool. Now you want to select the language, whether you should go with Java, C# or some other language, then you will come to know. If it is on Microsoft technology stack, you would most probably go with C#, otherwise you can go with Java. So this is why we should know about the technology stack. Now coming to the question, what are the ways and how do you find out the technology stack? So I will tell you three very useful tools which are open source and freely available, and they are basically Chrome extensions, so they are plugins over Chrome browser. So let us go to our browser and let me go to the extensions. So you can go to web store on your Chrome browser, and one of the extension is Webalyzer. So this is an extension that helps us in finding out the different technologies used to build the website. Another one is Built With. And in a moment, I will explain you how exactly you use these. And then there is another plugin called What Runs. So again, this is similar and it will tell you the different technology or frameworks used in the website. So for example, let us go to any website. I am going to my website, lifecharger.org. This is my blog. So let me go here. And I have already added all these extensions. So here you can see this is Webalyzer and you can see it here, and if I click here you can see it gives me all the details. It gives me the web framework, the scripting languages and web servers and JavaScript frameworks being used on this website. And similarly, if I go to this particular plugin which is What Runs and I click here again, it will give me all this information. So you can see the web framework is Bootstrap and web server is here, programming languages PHP and the dev tools and everything you can get here. And similarly is Built With. So this is Built With, and if I go here again, it will find out all the technologies, all the scripting languages and all the programmings. So this can be very, very simple and can be a very quick step, but it is going to be very useful. And when you start with automation, if you are going to be a automation engineer and if you want to be a very good and efficient automation engineer, then you should use these tools which are freely available and are very efficient, and within few seconds you can tell what tools are feasible, what you should use to go ahead with automation. So that was all in today's session of Q&A Friday. If you have any questions that you want me to feature in the next episode of Q&A Friday, you can write your questions in the comment section of this video, or you can also send me email at ask.qnafriday@gmail.com. I will meet you in the next episode. Thank you for watching.